following is a production of the University of Minnesota.
Football brings people together. It gives people an opportunity to really celebrate game day and all the festivities that go with game day.
I can promise you, when you now come to TCF Bank Stadium, that you're going to leave the stadium knowing that our young men played really hard, that the atmosphere is going to be very, very special. Every seat, every sight line is fantastic. The amenities for all of our fans, whether it be the restrooms, the concession stands, the wide corridors, the width of the seats, the treads between the seats, those are all things that we've done purposely so that we can really enhance the game day experience for all Minnesotans.
It's going to bring more people back to enjoy campus, which is what Saturday afternoon should be all about.
Whether it's the band playing a concert out on the plaza an hour before, or it's little sections of the band going to the tailgating lots, which are filled with maroon and gold flags and Minnesota flags.
We'll have activities around the stadium here. The athletic department will be doing some interactive events for families. There'll be a fun zone for families as well.
Also for alums coming back on campus now, they're coming to campus. They're not just coming to a Gopher football game, but they're coming on campus.
When Memorial Stadium was here, in the Dinkytown area, you could hear the game. You'd hear the roar of the crowd. You knew the Gophers had a touchdown. And everybody in the Dinkytown area would just sort of look and smile at each other that something good happened down the street. And I'm looking forward to that again with TCF Stadium.
That sense of community, people coming together, that will happen again. And I think those people will get connected as students and they'll remain connected throughout the rest of their lives.
It's been almost 28 years, I believe, since we've had a generation of students that have had the opportunity to experience this. And I really feel strongly that it's not just by being in the classroom that's important, but the whole socialization as a young adult really includes this experience.
There's a lot of pride in the state of Minnesota about the University of Minnesota. That was the really exciting thing about how this was for the state of Minnesota. It was for everybody. Whether you attended a game or not, whether you were an alum or not, this was about the state of Minnesota.
There are very few opportunities to bring this many Minnesotans back to campus or to campus to really connect with their land grant research university.
I think that's one of the things that's going to be really satisfying to a lot of people when they have a chance to actually come in here, see how magnificent it is, and to say, you know, this is mine. This is, I help pay for this. I'm a resident of Minnesota.
If one piece is missing, then the whole isn't whole. And I feel like we've brought a missing piece back to the University of Minnesota.
I know, I feel, I believe what a difference this stadium is going to make, what it's already making in the life of the university.
This makes us whole again.
In 2002, the state legislature asked the University of Minnesota and the Minnesota Vikings to conduct a joint use feasibility study.
It was clear from our work with the Vikings that we couldn't build a joint use stadium, that we were in different businesses. But that exercise of working with the Vikings really helped us understand why it was important to bring football back to campus.
And we began to think about what it would mean to have football on campus and what would that look like for our campus, what would we try to accomplish with a new stadium.
Each week,
The leaders of this university met on a Friday morning to plan this stadium every single step of the way.
And that is a group of the executive leaders from across the university, and then staff people that have worked through every phase from conception to planning to fundraising to construction to now execution to make this happen.
I think when they look back, that Friday group will probably be forgotten, but in the true story of this place was one of the more remarkable things that happened.
So that led to the 2003 feasibility study, which was really the first effort at what it would take to bring Gopher football back to campus.
The next huge hurdle for us, obviously, was getting money from the state legislature.
Without the taxpayers and the citizen support that came through the legislature, the project never would have happened.
We really needed to make our case for why it was important to make this kind of investment and build a stadium.
And there was a large effort through a grassroots effort to talk to people around the state, because legislators then heard from their constituents. It wasn't just hearing from the university's desire, they found that their constituents also wanted it.
Went to the legislature in 2004, 2005, 2006.
But in May of 2006, the state legislature committed $138 million to the stadium.
Wee hours in the morning, we have the president there, we've got the vice president, chief of staff, a number of government relations people, and everybody's up there high-fiving and cheering.
And then when the project got funded, oh my gosh, we had to get started.
Stay tuned for more on TCF Bank Stadium right after this.
In the early conversations about the stadium, there was some pushback from people at the university and in the public that this was going to be at the cost of our academic programming.
Certainly as a faculty member, you're always concerned when central administration makes a commitment to invest in something that is going to be as costly as a stadium, when you're concerned about other academic priorities, particularly in a very difficult economic time.
From the very beginning, I made a commitment to the faculty, students, and staff of the University of Minnesota and to our Board of Regents that the building of an on-campus football stadium would not compromise academic contributions. So we set out deliberately to leverage the stadium fundraising for the academic needs of the University of Minnesota.
Now, my first thought was, that's tough. Because normally in fundraising, you want to keep it simple, you know, KISS. It would be a more complex ask than when we would approach a donor prospect. But you know what?
Since that particular moment, we've raised more than $45 million in direct academic gifts.
So it is a win-win. The stadium is not taking away resources. It is, in fact, helping the academic mission of this university.
And we do need Minnesotans to support the academic and research mission of the university, just like they support the athletic events, and particularly football.
The very first gift we booked against the cost of the stadium came from the University of Minnesota Alumni Association.
Our board decided that money talks and early money shouts.
And I told them that I would gladly accept their gift if it was accompanied by a very strong commitment to student scholarships.
And it was time for major fundraising at all levels and grassroots fundraising.
The whole effort was raising money from individuals, it was raising money from corporations.
We also had financial issues for the students. It was clear that they were going to be beneficiaries in many ways from the stadium and the resources it brings to the campus, and so a contribution of them was expected.
We knew we couldn't build it. We knew we would have virtually no public credibility unless people were willing to step up and pay at least 60% of the cost. People of Minnesota, nearly 2,500 people, organizations, corporations gave back to their University of Minnesota and made this stadium a reality.
I looked around, I was afraid I'd see a ton of advertising. You're not gonna see, this is not a NASCAR. This is a college football stadium. I think people will be pleasantly surprised, even though there's a lot of corporate money in here, it's very subtle. It's not gonna in any way overwhelm the experience.
John and Nancy Lindahl, who co-chaired our fundraising, deserve very, very special mention. They worked tirelessly. Nancy herself, I think, visited close to 50 counties throughout the state of Minnesota, making the pitch for TCF Bank Stadium.
We've done it together. I think that's the best part. We put together two different skill sets. We didn't know that 5 years later we'd be standing here saying that it's been wonderful.
When we met with the architects to design the values and the principles that would guide their vision of the stadium, we said we wanted this stadium to blend the new with the old.
The university wanted a stadium that was very collegiate in terms of looks and feel, so a lot of discussion about brick.
We were really talking with the architects about what we thought a collegiate stadium should look like.
They make comments, say what they like and what they don't like, and we go back and make changes, and it constantly evolves almost up until you start construction.
We had a good process of selecting the architect, and I think we absolutely picked the right one. Same thing with the general contractor, with Mortensen.
The peak number of workers we did have on site was 750, and that lasted for approximately a month. But for the most part, we were pretty consistently for about a year to maybe 14 months, we had on average about 600 workers on site.
It was a boost to our economy, but also a building that was built with expertise and skill and pride of the Minnesota community.
I'm proud of the stadium mainly because Brian's worked on it, and I think it's going to be something that we can show our kids one day, like, hey, your dad was part of this.
Groundbreaking for the building itself was July 2nd, 2007.
Don't touch that dial. More on TCF Bank Stadium after this.
We wanted it to be a Minnesota stadium, and we've done that by honoring the past with the bricks, with the arches, with the 87 counties being represented, with the horseshoe, with the view of downtown.
This new stadium is incredible, and I've taken tours through it with other student groups, and the student reaction is just remarkable.
TCF Stadium is probably one of the great architectural buildings of this state.
Fits incredibly well on site. It's the right scale. It's oriented the right way.
When you look at this, you'd think, been here forever.
Colonnade Columns, we've come to see them as really members of the football team, kind of standing around with an inward focus to the field, just like the seats are an inward focus to the field too. Come to think of the field and the bowl where you sit, it's kind of like your living room. That's where you go to watch your games with your friends and your family.
On the perimeter stadium wall, we have all of the 87 counties represented in the wall.
You can talk about this is the state stadium. Nothing drives that home better than people who come to this stadium and look up and say, I see my county.
It's going to be impossible to get lost in TCF Bank Stadium. You can say, I will meet you at Cook County or Coochaching County or Hennepin County.
When we designed TCF Bank Stadium, we actually had two primary stakeholders in mind, and that was the fan experience and the student athlete experience. And so some of the things that you think about here that might cater to both, the scoreboard, is something that you can't miss when you come into TCF Bank Stadium.
We've got the third largest scoreboard in all of college football. It's 110 feet long, 50 feet wide, top of the line technology from Daktronix. We're able to do tons of things here that we've never been able to do before for our sponsors, for our fans.
The artificial turf really was the right decision because it is a multi-purpose facility and because we want it to last for at least 10 years. It's 40% sand, 60% rubber infill. And the nice thing about it is we don't have to water it, we don't have to cut it, we don't have to paint it. We can use it for all of the uses that we need to use it for without worrying about the wear and tear on it.
The original stadium was named Memorial Stadium in honor of World War I veterans. Bob Brunix wanted to have a way to properly honor the veterans, past, current, and future. It is 18 feet high, 72 feet long. It has the official American flag for the stadium with duty on our country on the outside and on the inside. It has Minnesota veteran tribute, thank you for our freedom.
Tribal Nations Plaza was designed to showcase or represent the 11
11 tribal nations in Minnesota, and to provide many, many people that will pass through here a learning opportunity as to the locations of the tribes and a little history about each and every tribe located here in Minnesota.
I'm really fond of the student arch. Hats off to thee.
The stadium committee came up to the student government and asked what would be significant for students at the U, and hats off to thee really seemed to fit.
We thought hats off to thee was really symbolic because tipping your hats to the students, thank you for your contribution.
And it'll remind people that we could not have built this stadium without the contributions of students.
I love the open concourses.
Here the corridors are 2 to 2.5 times larger than they are in the Metrodome.
The open concourses really add to the fan experience in that you're able to grab a hot dog or a soda and you're still engaged. You can still hear it, feel it, see it, really engage in the action on the field. The sight lines in TCF Bank Stadium are second to none. And I say this without hesitancy, there's not a bad seat in TCF Bank Stadium. Whether you're in the top row of the second level or the first row of the first level, every vantage point in TCF Bank Stadium is a phenomenal seat.
We've got wide seats, we've got great treads between them.
Suites are great. They seat up to 19 people. It's a luxury suite. It also has radiant heat for those November days.
Now, I've watched a lot of football games over the years, and I have never experienced football like this. The club seats are absolutely the best seats in the house. Of course, there really isn't a bad seat in the house here. But I got to tell you, to watch play formation, how everything's going to come out, you can see it perfectly.
A loge box is a premium seating amenity that's like a mini suite is the best way to think of it, but it's not a suite. You're sitting outside.
I think it's a wonderful way to watch the game. I think you have the excitement of being outside.
10,000 seats were reserved for students. And when they were thinking about which students would receive tickets, we thought 8,000 should be reserved for students coming into the next year, and then 2,000 should be reserved for first-year students. It seemed to work really well. We sold 6,500 tickets the first weekend that tickets went on sale, and then after that, they just sold out like crazy.
They'll be sitting behind the goalposts right by the marching band. There will be a lot of excitement coming from that side of the end zone.
One of the most unique features of TCF Bank Stadium is the home team locker room. And I tell you, when you walk in the home team locker room, pictures and descriptions and videos don't do it justice. It is what I'd call the crown jewel of TCF Bank Stadium in that it's 60 yards long, 25 yards wide, 120 custom-built cherry wood lockers.
Yeah, it doesn't look like my high school locker room, I must admit.
Sustainability was a very important priority for us in building TCF Bank Stadium, and so we did seek LEED certification.
LEED is a third-party benchmarking system for green buildings.
We're very, very proud to be the first LEED certified college football facility in America.
I think the accessibility all around the stadium is great, no matter where you sit, on the premium seats and the regular seats. Fabulous. You get close to the action. They're very accessible. You don't have people standing up in front of you. I think they did a terrific job here.
Probably the biggest resistance when we went out to the service clubs is how could you spend $288 million for a stadium that's going to be used 7 days during the year? Well, our message was very clear. It's going to be used 365 days out of the year.
The stadium will also be used for intramural sports, sport club practices, all through recreational sports.
The number of students on campus that participate in rec sports grows every year. So the fact that rec sports can use the stadium throughout the year, another great benefit of having the stadium back on campus.
It'll be used with the kinesiology department for physical education classes. The marching band will use it. They have a space inside that they'll get to use for recording music and practicing.
Our facility here in TCF Bank Stadium is about 20,000 square feet. In it we have this room we're standing in, which is 80 by 100 foot. We have 260 winds and 30 percussionists in the band right now. We can actually fit in this room with acoustical treatings. We have a rotunda which holds some of our historical documents and artifacts that people can come in and see. We have two other smaller rehearsal rooms where we can break down into smaller groups and get more work done. Two full locker rooms with showers, and then a lot of storage for a lot of instruments and a lot of uniforms.
It's just glorious. Everything's so like new, and there's more technology, and it's just great.
Walking into the Taj Mahal here, this is amazing. This is high tech. This is the best in the Big Ten, probably the best in the country.
Love the DQ Club Room. Many people in Minnesota are going to be able to have access to that and to use that, whether it be for meetings, whether it be for our students and career fairs, whether it be banquets, or whether it be a wedding reception that maybe students or others in the community would utilize that for.
Great parking, so the corporate community, easy place to find, to come into campus, to have a chance to interact with our students.
Please stay tuned for more on TCF Bank Stadium.
What amazes me is the team effort that went into this. No one person can pull off a building like this.
And the executives that come to meet with me each day and every week will tell me without hesitation that this is probably the best experience they've had of working together as a team and creating something much greater than themselves.
I think there were several things that made it successful. First and foremost, I think we have a courageous leader.
President Brunick's vision for bringing football back to campus and his commitment and dedication to doing so has really manifested itself in the success of this project.
If it were not for his vision, his courage, and his leadership, we would not be here.
And I like to think that one of the things I brought to this effort was the vision that it was important and the tenacity to get the job done.
One, two, three, go!